So we look forward to Coach McDermott and his staff leading our program to the same level of success that we've achieved in some of our other programs. And I look forward to working alongside of him for quite a long time.
What a difference a couple of weeks makes. After seeing Wesley Johnson, Lucas Steiger, Justin Hamilton, Chris Colvin, Dominique Buckley, and others leave the Iowa State program before their eligibility expired, Greg McDermott decided to pull up stakes as well. Mac today announcing he was leaving Iowa State to take the head coaching spot at Creighton University in Omaha. KCCI's Scott Reister is live in Ames. Scott, this isn't even a lateral move. Why did Mac make this move less than 2 months after getting a vote of confidence?
Well, this really came out of left field. First of all, this wasn't something he had planned on or even thought about, but then when the job came open, the athletic director at Creighton, Bruce Rasmussen, loves McDermott back from when McDermott coached at UNI and coached against Creighton, so he has a lot of respect for him. Contacted McDermott, offered him a 10-year deal, terms not disclosed, but it's thought to be comparable annually to what he's making now, so he has more job security at Iowa State. Only has 5 years left on his deal, plus obviously some people thinking that he might not finish those 5 years out, so he's going to a place where he is loved by the AD, as a 10-year deal, and most importantly, according to him, his son Doug, who started Ames last year, was going to go to UNI, is now instead going to go play for his dad at Creighton. So you add it all up, and this was a move that he says he has to make for his family, but still, he agonized over this decision and didn't decide until 1 o'clock today.
It was an unbelievably hard decision. I've had, you know, two in-person meetings with Jamie the last couple days and several phone conversations. You know, the emotional attachment that I have to this place and the people I work with, the people I coach, the people I work for, and a lot of great friends we have here makes it tough to leave. That, and I don't feel like I finished a job.
I mean, he felt really like it was hard to say it, but same time, I mean, it's a business at the end of the day. It's always going to be a business, and he's doing what's right for him.
Jamie Pollard had this statement, nothing but support for him. He says, I know this was a very difficult decision for Greg and his family. The contract terms that Creighton offered him and an opportunity to coach his son were significant factors in his decision. We wish Greg the best of luck at Creighton. So there you have it, signed, sealed, and delivered. And right now, Iowa State looking for a coach, joined now live by Andy Ireland. And Andy, where does this leave Iowa State, and what's everyone saying about the future of the Cyclone basketball program?
Yeah, it leaves them in a world of hurts, really. Late April is a tough time to get a coach. And I talked to Gary Thompson, maybe the face of this Iowa State program, the Roland Rocket. He's been a Cyclone fan his whole life, and even he really isn't too crushed by this move.
Frankly, as I look at it right now, I think it might be the best for both parties because I don't think that Iowa State, looking at it as a fan of Iowa State, that our basketball program is going anywhere in the next couple of years for sure. And for McDermott, he gets a nice contract at Creighton and moves on, and so I think it can benefit both parties.
Pretty telling words there from Gary Thompson. He's okay with the move now. Our coverage doesn't end here tonight. Of course, we'll have more at 10. And I'm going to Omaha tomorrow to see Greg McDermott get introduced as Creighton's new head coach tomorrow at 10:30.
Wild stuff, Andy. That'll do it from here. Andy, back to you.